OS and RTE profiling for TriCore AURIX. Trace recording and export with TRACE32. Vector and Lauterbach have developed a joint solution that allows to record trace information about the timing behavior of tasks, interrupts, and runnables for Vector's AUTOSAR classic basic software, MicroSAR, and to analyze it with the help of the TA inspection timing tool from Vector. Please refer to the following video for an overview about this joint solution. This video explains steps 2 and 3, the trace recording and the export of the trace information in a format that is readable by the TA tool suite. For this video, we are using TRACE32 PowerView for TriCore release of February 2020. A Power Debug Pro with a Power Trace serial connected to a Tri-Board Evaluation Board from Infineon, with a TC397XE, which has 6 AURIX cores and the Trace and Trigger Logic MCDS running a Vector's AUTOSAR classic basic software MicroSAR, where the OS timing hooks have already been enabled in order to signal the events of interest. Before we can make the trace recording, various setup steps are necessary. First, we need to establish a debug connection between TRACE32 and all the 6 CPUs of our TriCore AURIX processor, and program the flash memory with Vector's AUTOSAR classic basic software MicroSAR. Then we need to load the debug symbols with the help of the data.load.elf command. To make the TRACE32 find all necessary OS information, the ORTE file, which has been generated when building the OS, has to be loaded with the task.ORTE command. With our next step, we have to configure TRACE32 for the use of the trace module PowerTrace serial. We need to program the TriCore Trace and Trigger Logic MCDS to only record the trace information for the events generated by the Vector timing hooks. This is done by calling a script. The script is available in the TRACE32 demo directory, as well as for download on the Lauterbach website, and supports AURIX, as well as AURIX second generation TriCore processors with all MCDS variants. The last step is to call the script rte-runnable.cmm in order to read the runnable ID mapping. The script is generated when building the MicroSAR classic basic software. Let's execute now our script. We use the Go button to start the program execution on the target in order to perform the trace recording. Break stops the measurement. By recording only the information of interest, much longer recording times can be achieved in comparison to a full program trace. Trace information can also be streamed to a file on the host computer, which allows even longer measuring times. Now the trace can be exported with the following command trace.export.taskevents. As a result, we get a comma-separated values format, which can then be imported into the Vector's TA tool suite in order to analyze the timing behavior and validate the system requirements. If you want to check the trace data before the export, you can do this in a TRACE32 PowerView user interface using different commands. These commands show timing charts, statistic tables, or colored profiling charts. This is everything I wanted to show you in this video. Thank you for your attention.